I was born in 1955, and before I ever knew anything about the world, there was a revolution in Cuba that changed everything for that nation. And by the mid-60s, I was in elementary school, and I remember the Cuban missile crisis and the embargo and all those things, but it really didn't impact my personal life except the concern about missiles coming in to the United States and so on, but it greatly impacted the lives of the people of Cuba. And in 2012, at General Conference, it was announced that from 1958 until 2012, there had never been a building permit granted in Cuba for a church. But the Wesleyan Church had been granted the opportunity to build a building. A few months later, John Croft was here for the Missional Holiness Conference, and we were talking, sitting around the table at Red Robin, and I was asking him some questions, and he said, "Would you be interested in going to Cuba?" I said, "Are you kidding? That's not even a dream. I never even dreamed that would ever be possible." And so he contacted Rick West, and that particular trip was already filled up because of limitations of where lodging there in Cuba, at the home where they were staying. But Rick worked it out that I could go the next year, and then I was invited back the second year. And that first trip, the Jesus Film Partnership training was held at Pedro Bendicourt. I don't know if that's pronounced correctly or not, but that's where Pastor Younio is. And I was able to be in his church, which is also part of his home. As his church grows, his home has to decrease because they have to set aside space in their home for the church. But I was in his church, I was in his home, I ate at his table, and I love his wife's cooking, and she knows that, his wife Nancy. They're such gracious hosts. And then this past spring, I was invited to go back again for an evangelism conference in Cardenas, where they learned how to share their faith. They went out in the street, and in about 1 hour, they led over 50 people to the Lord, and that Sunday, they started a new church. And so I am highly, highly privileged to have ever stepped foot on Cuban soil, but even more highly honored to have a friend, Pastor Younio Gonzalez, to be able to be here in the church I pastor and share with us this morning. And he's going to preach in Cuban. That's easier for him. If you talk to him, he understands much and can communicate pretty well. He knows the word Orioles real well. And he can converse, but he does his teaching in Cuban, and so or in Spanish. So Rick West, who knows all the dialects of Spanish, he can even fool the Cubans. They think he's from Cuba when he's there. He's going to do the translation for us, and we will understand every word. But more than that, may we be listening to the voice of the Holy Spirit as Pastor Younio and Rick come and share the word of God with us this morning. God bless you, my brothers.
Hello.
Hola.
How do you feel today?
How are you? ¿Cómo están hoy?
Bueno, el pastor Dwight me presentó.
Well, Pastor Dwight made our presentation.
Hoy se está haciendo un sueño realidad.
And today, a dream that I've had is becoming a reality.
Y un milagro realidad también.
And it's also a miracle as well.
Que esté aquí es un milagro de Dios.
The fact that I'm here to me is just a miracle of God.
Nosotros vivimos en Cuba cada día a través de los milagros.
Each day we live in Cuba by way of miracles.
Literalmente vivimos por milagros.
I mean, literally, we live miracles.
No quiero hablarles mucho de Cuba. Puede ser que en la conferencia hable un poco más de Cuba.
I won't be saying a whole lot about Cuba this morning because in the conference I will be talking about Cuba.
Me dijeron que tenía 20 minutos.
They told me I had 20 minutes.
¿Cuántos me dan 5 minutos?
How many will give me 5 minutes? There's five.
Five.
There's five. Ten, five.
20. I'm sorry, Pastor.
Sorry, Pastor.
The people.
The people win.
Oh, praise the Lord. Mi nombre es Younio Gonzalez.
My name is Younio Gonzalez.
Estoy casado con una linda esposa.
I am married to a beautiful wife.
Es verdad que es linda.
And she is beautiful.
Sí. Un regalo del Señor.
And just a gift from God.
Tenemos un pequeño bebé.
We have one baby.
Tiene 15 años.
He's 15 years old.
Él toca la batería en la iglesia.
He plays the drum set in the church.
Desde los 13 años de sirviendo al Señor.
And from 3 years old, he's been serving the Lord.
Y es nuestro único hijo.
And he's our only son.
Mi esposa era estéril y no podía tener hijos.
My wife was sterile. She could not have children.
En el año 98.
But in 1998.
Una persona nos dijo que Dios le había dicho que íbamos a tener un bebé.
But a person told us, you're going to have a child.
Anoté la fecha en mi Biblia.
And so I wrote down the date in my Bible.
Fue el 28 de noviembre del 98.
And it was the 28th of November, 1998.
Y el 23 de noviembre del 99.
And the 23rd of November, 1999.
Estaba naciendo mi hijo.
My son was born.
Su nombre es... su nombre es Nehemías.
His name is Nehemiah. Nehemías.
Porque fue un consuelo para nosotros.
Because he was like a comfort to us.
Yo crecí en un hogar comunista.
I grew up in a communist home.
Nunca mi familia se creyó en nada.
None of my family believed in nothing.
No practicaban ninguna religión.
They didn't practice any religion.
Solo la religión del comunismo.
And their religion was communism.
Nunca en mi vida escuché de Jesucristo.
And all my life I hadn't heard of Jesus Christ.
Nunca en mi vida vi una Biblia delante de mis ojos.
I had never seen a Bible in front of my eyes.
Pasaba por las iglesias y pensaba que eran locos.
And I walked by church and I thought, this is a bunch of crazy people.
Pero en el año, cuando tenía 21 años,
but when I was 21 years old,
estaba en el ejército.
I was in the army.
En Cuba el ejército es obligatorio para todos los años.
Because in Cuba it's the draft system, it's obligatory to serve 2 years.
Y hice algo muy malo en el ejército.
And I did something very bad in the army.
Me costaba varios años de prisión.
And I had to spend various years in prison.
Y de alguna manera clamé a Dios.
But I still cried out to God.
Y Dios me libró literalmente.
And God literally liberated me from there.
De la prisión.
He liberated me from prison.
Y eso fue lo que me hizo ir a una iglesia.
And that's what caused me to go to a church.
Entré en la iglesia en el año 94.
I went into a church in 1994.
Y a los dos meses he convertido.
And just 2 months after I was converted.
Ya era misionero.
They named me as a missionary.
Prediqué mi primer mensaje a los dos meses.
And so I'd only been saved 2 months and I preached my first message.
A los cuatro años de convertido.
And after being saved 4 years,
ya era pastor a tiempo completo.
Then I was a full-time pastor.
Y tenía cuatro iglesias.
And I had 4 churches.
Para la gloria de Dios.
For the glory of God.
Aleluya. Actualmente estamos trabajando con 22 iglesias.
Right now in my district, there are 3 districts in Cuba. In my district, there are 22 churches.
Empecé hace 12 años en ese distrito.
I began 12 years ago in that area, in that district.
El único pastor que estaba ahí.
And I was the only pastor there.
Y a partir de 12 años a la actualidad hemos fundado 22 iglesias.
But from that time till now we've been able to plant 22 churches.
Ya le dije al Señor, vamos a parar un ratico, ¿no?
And so I said, Lord, we're going to slow down here a little bit.
Dame un chance.
Give me a chance, Lord, to catch up.
Porque es mucho el trabajo.
Because the work was tremendous.
Pero estamos contentos.
But we're very happy.
Porque Dios está haciendo la obra.
Because God is doing the work.
Y a él le damos la gloria y la
and
obra.
To him we give Hallelujah. The honor and the glory.
Praise the Lord.
Gloria a Dios.
Quiero traer la palabra del Señor. Después le hablaré unas cosas de Cuba.
I'm going to look to the word of the Lord, and then we'll be talking about Cuba along the way. If you have your Bibles, you want to look at 1 Thessalonians 1 7. 1 Thessalonians 1 7.
Hallelujah.
1 Thessalonians 1 7.
You got it?
Are you there?
Aleluya. Dice la palabra del Señor.
And the word of the Lord says,
de tal manera que habéis sido ejemplo a todos los de Macedonia y Acaya que han creído.
So that you became examples to all in Macedonia and Acacia who believe.
Porque partiendo de vosotros ha sido divulgada la palabra del Señor no solo en Macedonia y Acaya, sino también en todo lugar vuestra fe en Dios se ha extendido, de modo que nosotros no tenemos necesidad de hablar nada.
For from you the word of the Lord has sounded forth, not only in Macedonia and Acacia, but also in every place. Your
Amen.
Yeah.
Cuando yo estudiaba este pasaje,
when I studied this passage,
ayer en la mañana en Miami,
and I was studying it again yesterday in Miami,
yo le decía al Señor, dame una palabra para la iglesia del Pastor Dwight.
I said, Lord, give me a word for the church where Pastor Dwight is.
Porque no me gusta traer las palabras preparadas desde Cuba.
I don't like to bring the word that I've already prepared for Cuba.
Me gusta comerme el pan calentico.
Because I like to eat fresh bread.
Un pan viejo hace daño.
He said, you know, an old bread, that could cause you harm.
Y entonces, este pan está acabadito de sacar del horno.
And so, remember, this bread is just right now taken out of the oven.
Y de alguna manera Dios te va a hablar en esta mañana.
And God's going to speak to us this morning.
Esta iglesia tesalónica, Pablo decía,
and this church in Macedonia, Paul said,
de que no había necesidad de hablar nada.
That it wasn't necessary to talk to them about anything.
Porque ellos habían sido ejemplo.
Because they had been an example.
A toda Macedonia y Acaya.
They had been example to Macedonia and Acacia.
Estamos hablando de una ciudad.
That we're talking about a city.
Que había sido ejemplo a toda una región.
That had been example to their whole region.
Y Pablo habla de cómo ellos habían convertido de los ídolos a Dios.
And Paul talks about how they were transformed from the idols to God.
Pablo dice de que ellos habían convertido en imitadores de Cristo.
And that they had converted to become imitators of Christ.
Esta ciudad era una ciudad muy idólatra.
And this was a very idolatrous city.
Ella tenía, como decir, una avenida central.
And they had, like we would say, a central street or a main street.
Y tenía muchos templos paganos.
And they had many pagan temples.
Tenía templos al dios Zeus.
They had temples to Zeus.
Templo Artemisa.
And Artemisa.
Había otro templo que era un dios llamado Baco.
And there is another one dedicated to the god of Baco.
Y eran muy, muy, muy idólatras en esa ciudad.
And they were very idolatrous in that city.
Pero el evangelio llegó ahí.
But the gospel came to that area.
De una manera poderosa.
In a powerful way.
Que no había necesidad de hablar.
And it wasn't even necessary to talk.
Porque ellos daban testimonio.
Because the church had given testimony.
Del Dios vivo en que creían.
Of a living God that they had experienced.
Y si usted va y lee la sobre Éfeso,
and if you go and you read about the church in Ephesus,
es parecido.
It's very similar.
En Antioquía.
And in Antioch as well.
Y yo veo todo este crecimiento,
and I see all this growth.
Y me pregunto, ¿qué tenían ellos que no tenemos nosotros?
And I begin to think, well, what do they have that we don't have?
Porque la situación también estaba difícil en ese lugar.
Because it was very difficult. Area where the church entered.
Recuerda que existía la persecución.
Remember, there was persecution.
No solamente el Imperio Romano.
Not just by the Roman persecution.
Sino de los mismos judíos sobre los gentiles.
But the Jews who were persecuting Christians.
La religión judía quería judaizar al cristianismo.
And so the Jews wanted to make the Christians Judaizers.
Pero había crecimiento.
But there was growth.
Hay una palabra que Jesús dio.
There's a word that Jesus gave.
Del reino.
He gave about the kingdom.
Que Jesús compara el reino con la levadura.
And Jesus compares the kingdom to yeast.
La levadura es algo que se usa.
Yeast is something that we use.
Para dar crecimiento a la harina.
And it makes the flour grow.
Y Jesús dijo que el reino de Dios era semejante a una porción de levadura.
And so Jesus said that the kingdom is comparable to one little piece of leaven known as yeast.
Que una mujer echó en una masa.
And that when you put just a little bit in the mass of the flour,
y al cabo del tiempo, esa masa creció.
And then just leave it there a little while, it'll rise, it'll grow.
En otras palabras, el reino de los cielos,
And in other words, the kingdom of God,
siempre debe estar en crecimiento.
The kingdom of heaven must always be growing.
Pero ¿qué ha pasado?
But what's happened?
¿Por qué entonces no estamos creciendo?
Why aren't we growing?
¿Por qué crecemos torcidos?
Why are we growing sometimes, you know, a little crooked?
Porque hay otra levadura.
Because there's other types of yeast.
Que se parece a la del reino.
The other types of yeast that is very similar. It looks like the yeast of the kingdom.
Pero no es levadura del reino.
But it's not the yeast of the kingdom.
Aleluya. En la palabra del Señor en Marcos capítulo 8.
And also in Mark chapter 8.
Verso 15.
Verse 15. Mark 8:15.
Dice ahí la palabra del Señor.
And the word of the Lord says.
Dice, y él les mandó diciendo, mirad, guardaos de la levadura de los fariseos y de la levadura de Herodes.
And he charged them saying, take heed, beware of the leaven of the Pharisees and the leaven of Herod.
Entonces, hay tres tipos de levadura.
And so there's at least three types of leaven, three types of yeast.
Jesús menciona tres tipos de levadura.
Jesus mentions three types of yeast or leaven.
La levadura del reino.
The leaven of the kingdom.
La levadura de los fariseos.
The leaven of the Pharisees.
Y la levadura de Herodes.
And the leaven of Herod.
En el libro de Gálatas.
And in Galatians.
En el capítulo 5.
In Galatians chapter 5.
Pablo le dice a los Gálatas.
Paul speaks to the Galatian church and says,
recuerden que un poco de levadura,
and he says, remember that just a little bit of leaven
leuda toda la masa.
Will leaven the whole mass.
Había un problema en Galacias,
there was a problem in among the Galatian church
con el judaísmo.
Because Judaism was very strong pressure on the Christians.
Pablo decía a los Gálatas, permanecer firme.
But Paul says to the Galatians, remain firm.
Por la libertad que Cristo los hizo libres.
Remain firm in the liberty that Christ has given you.
Pablo le dice a los Gálatas insensato, ¿quién os fascinó?
And he said, Galatians, who has taken you off course?
Para habiendo empezado por el Espíritu, terminar por la ley.
They had begun with the Spirit, but they ended up with the law.
Y esa es la levadura de los fariseos.
And that's the leaven of the Pharisees.
Que quería contaminar la iglesia de Galacia.
That they wanted to contaminate the church of the Galatians.
Porque algunos querían que se circuncidaran los gentiles.
Because some were saying, nope, men, you must be circumcised.
Eso era una pequeña porción de levadura.
And that was just a little bit of the leaven that the Judaizers were inserting into the church.
Que le iba a quitar la libertad.
And we're going to take away the liberty
que el Espíritu lo había dado
that the Spirit had already given to the church.
A la iglesia.
To the church.
Porque la ley esclaviza, hermano.
Because the law will always make us slaves.
Y hoy en día tenemos eso en la iglesia también.
And today we have some of those same issues in
no
the churches
pidiendo,
as well.
No estamos pidiendo que guarden el sábado.
Sometimes they're saying, no, you must obey the Sabbath and worship the Lord only on the Sabbath day.
No pedimos que
that
si,
is the
que
Saturday.
Que si circunciden.
And so then, and sometimes talk about circumcision as well.
Pero entonces, pastor, ¿cuándo nos damos cuenta que ha entrado levadura de fariseos dentro de nuestra iglesia?
But when we as pastors can recognize when there's other types of leaven that's been introduced into the church.
Cuando hay legalismo.
When there's legalism within us.
Cuando hay religiosidad.
When there's religiousness among us.
Está entrando un poco levadura fariseal a la iglesia.
Then there's a little bit of the Pharisees leaven entering
y esa
the
levadura
church.
Retiene el crecimiento.
And that type of leaven will hold the church back from growth.
Porque empezamos a poner dogmas de hombres.
Because then we start putting dogmas that are from man.
Pablo le decía, perdón, Jesús le decía a los fariseos.
Because Jesus said to the Pharisees,
ustedes quebrantan el mandamiento.
You break the law
cuando se aferran a las tradiciones.
When you try to hang on to your tradition.
Y las tradiciones son buenas.
Traditions are good. We understand that.
Pero no pueden detener el crecimiento de Dios.
But traditions cannot hold us back from growth.
Un pastor amigo mío,
a pastor, a friend of mine,
lo mandan para una iglesia presbiteriana en Cuba.
And they sent my pastor friend to a Presbyterian church in Cuba.
Y es una iglesia muy tradicional.
And it's a very traditional church.
Tiene grandes edificios.
They have huge, beautiful buildings.
Pero pocas personas.
But they have only a few people on the inside.
Entonces tenía un grupito de viejitas.
And so the pastor, when he arrived, there was just a few small group of older ladies.
Pero eran muy legalistas.
But they were very legalistic.
Y cuando él llegó,
and when the pastor came,
no le gustó el piano donde estaba.
He didn't like where the piano had been sitting.
Y tomó el piano de ahí y lo subió a la plazoleta.
And so he took the piano from there and he put it over on this corner.
Cuando las viejitas llegaron,
and when the older ladies arrived,
¿qué ha hecho, pastor?
He said, "Pastor, what are you doing here?
Yo llevo 30 años en esta iglesia.
I've been here 30 years.
Y el piano siempre estaba ahí.
And the piano was always on this side.
¿Cómo usted va a cambiarlo?
How are you going to change the pastor, the piano that side?
Ponga el piano donde va.
Put the piano back where it was.
El pastor tuvo que coger el piano.
Well, pastor had to take the piano and put it back.
Y lo puso. Pero comenzó cada domingo.
But he started each Sunday.
Cogía el piano y lo corría.
But each Sunday he just moved it a little bit.
Y todo el mundo contento.
And they didn't notice. Everybody
no se daban cuenta. El otro domingo
next Sunday,
el piano un poquito. Y la viejita contenta.
And the ladies were happy.
Al cabo de seis meses,
and after 6 months,
ya el pastor tenía el piano.
Now the pastor had the piano.
Donde lo había puesto.
It's over there where he put it.
Hermanos,
brothers,
es una legalismo.
Legalism
pone barrera.
Will sometimes put obstacles
a lo que Dios quiere hacer.
To what God wants to do.
Es que siempre lo hemos hecho así.
And we've always been that way.
Es hora de cambiar.
It's time to change.
Es hora de cambiar.
It's time to change.
Lo que no cambia es porque está muerto.
Because if it's not changed, if it's not growing, it's dead.
Las iglesias pasan por cuatro etapas.
The churches always go through four different stages.
Que yo le llamo las cuatro M's. Cuatro M's.
I call them the four M's. I see how this works out in Spanish.
Yeah.
In English. Go ahead.
Es mejor para que usted se lo grabe. La primera M es etapa misionera.
The first stage is mission.
Es una etapa linda.
And that's a beautiful time.
Donde todo es bello.
Everything is beautiful.
El Espíritu Santo está ahí.
The Holy Spirit is moving.
Hay mucha pasión.
There's much passion.
Las personas se convierten.
People are converted.
Las personas se sanan.
And people are healed.
Como la iglesia de Éfeso.
Just like in the church in Ephesus.
En Hechos 19.
In Acts 19.
Estuvo dos años haciendo Pablo milagros extraordinarios.
Because for 2 years in Ephesus, in that place, Paul, there were great miracles that were happening.
Después viene la segunda M.
But then the second M comes.
Es la etapa ministerial.
And the next one is ministry. The second M is ministry.
Es donde empezamos a organizar la iglesia.
That's when we begin to organize the church.
Y creamos los ministerios.
And we create the various ministries within the church.
Empezamos a tener una banda de música.
We start to have a worship team.
Los que trabajan con los niños.
Those that work with children.
Los que oran.
Those that pray.
Y varios ministerios.
And various ministries.
Es buena esa etapa.
Various ministries within the church, and that's a very important time.
La tercera M.
But the third M.
Es la etapa mantenimiento.
But the third one, sometimes the church drifts into what is called maintenance.
Es donde la iglesia cae en un stop y empiezan a mantenerse.
When the church comes to a stop and then just begin to maintain, right?
Ya tenemos todo lo que necesitamos.
Oh, we got everything we need.
Ya tenemos un lindo templo.
We have a beautiful building.
Tenemos buenos instrumentos.
We have good instruments.
Cómodos asientos.
We have seats that are very comfortable.
Personas que damos sus buenos diezmos.
And people that are tithing well.
Ahora es mantenernos.
And now just maintain. Let's just maintain where we are.
Yo estuve en esa etapa.
I was in that stage.
A nivel de Cuba, por supuesto.
I was in that stage, of course, in the Cuban context.
Y me acomodé.
And I was very comfortable.
Tenía una iglesia casi 200 personas.
I had a church of almost 200 people.
Es una iglesia grande en Cuba.
In Cuba, a church of 200 is a mega church.
Yo estaba acomodado.
And I was very comfortable.
Vino un pastor un día.
And a pastor came one day.
Y me dijo, dice el Señor que haga las primeras obras.
And the pastor said, the Lord said to do your first works.
Yo soy un plantador de iglesia.
I'm a planter. I'm a church planter.
Me quedé en ocho iglesias plantadas.
And so then I began planting churches. And when I got to eight, that's where I stopped.
Le dije, dile al Señor.
And he said, tell the Lord.
De que se busca otra gente, que yo estoy cansado.
And when I had eight, I said, Lord, look for somebody else because, yeah, I'm tired.
Yo no quería pasar más trabajo.
I didn't want to have more work to do.
En Cuba tenemos que caminar 5 o 6 kilómetros para abrir una iglesia.
Sometimes in Cuba we have to walk.
No tenemos
5-6 kilometers to get to open a church.
No tenemos carro.
We don't have a car.
Ahora que tenemos bicicleta.
But now we have bicycles.
Hace un año, dos años que tenemos bicicleta.
2 years ago we started receiving bicycles.
El salario de una persona en Cuba es de $30 mensuales.
The salary of a person in Cuba, the average salary is about $30 a month.
Mensuales, dije.
A month, I said.
No diario.
Not day.
No semanales.
not a week, a month.
Por eso le decía que en Cuba vivimos con milagros diarios.
And so for that reason I said in the beginning, every day in Cuba we live miracles.
Entonces tienes que ir a predicar el evangelio.
And so if you have to go preach the gospel
caminar,
somewhere, you have to walk there.
Llegar a un lugar de mucha pobreza.
And you get there and it's just very poor area.
Sin tú tener para ayudarles.
And if you don't have something in your hand to help the people,
y pensando,
you have to go thinking,
que vas a comer hoy en tu casa.
You have to think, what am I going to eat? What is my family going to eat when I get home?
Una persona en mi primer viaje a Estados Unidos, una persona me dijo, ¿qué es lo más difícil para un pastor en Cuba?
In my first trip to the United States about 3 years ago, someone asked me, what's the greatest challenge for you in Cuba?
Es mantener a su familia.
And I said, to feed my family.
Porque en Cuba todo es ilegal.
Because everything in Cuba, so many things are illegal. This is illegal, that's illegal.
Las personas viven con $30 porque necesitan estar robando para poder vivir.
And so often, since people can't live on $30, they're stealing
y como uno
pastor, in order to live.
Uno no puede hacer lo mismo que hacen ellos.
But when you're a pastor, you can't be stealing.
Entonces tiene que vivir por la
so
fe.
You have to live depending on God to supply the need.
Pero Dios me dijo, haz las primeras obras.
But the Lord said, go do your first works.
Y hermano, tuve que hacerlo.
And I had to do it.
Porque no me dejaba tranquilo.
Because I couldn't have peace in my spirit without doing it.
La cuarta etapa de una iglesia.
And the fourth level of a church, the fourth phase of a church,
donde nunca podemos caer,
and it's where we can never get to this place.
Es la etapa monumento.
And the top, and the last phase is what we call the monument phase.
Son las iglesias que están por ahí muy lindas, catedrales.
It's those churches that are very beautiful cathedrals,
pero están vacías.
But they're empty.
No tienen el amor.
There has no love.
La pasión.
There's no passion.
El fuego.
There's no fire.
Nada.
There's nothing.
Ni personas tiene.
Don't you have people?
Entonces, esta levadura farisea.
And so this yeast, this leaven from the Pharisees.
Es la que nos lleva a estancarnos.
Is what leads us to grind to a halt.
A poner rudimentos sobre las personas que no pueden llevar.
And then to put heavy burdens on people that they themselves can't
y las personas
bear.
Cuando llegan a Cristo, en vez de sentir libertad,
and the people when they come to Christ instead of feeling liberty,
lo que siente es otra carga más.
What they feel is like, oh, the burden down even more.
Porque le llenamos de leyes de hombres.
Because we put laws of man upon their shoulders.
Yo sé que eso aquí no pasa.
I know this don't happen
eso
here.
Pasa en Cuba, más.
That's only in Cuba where that happens.
Hay muchos de nosotros que estamos pasando por esas etapas.
But there's many of us
porque
who
somos la iglesia.
Are who are going through those various phases because we're a church. Maybe you're at this phase of just maintaining.
Yo estoy manteniéndome.
I'm just maintaining myself.
Ya sé cómo alzar las manos.
I know how to raise my hands.
Ya sé decir las palabras correctas.
I know how to say the right words.
Me he vuelto un profesional de la fe.
I am a professional in the faith.
Pero Dios quiere más de ti.
But God wants more from you.
Y Dios te está diciendo, despiértate.
And he's saying, wake up.
Levántate.
Rise up.
Porque nunca vas a dejar de crecer.
Because you'll never quit growing
hasta que Cristo venga a buscarte.
Until Jesus Christ comes to take you.
No importa la edad que tengas.
It doesn't matter what age you are.
La levadura de fariseos,
the leaven from the Pharisee, from the Pharisees
se resiste al cambio.
Is very resistant to change.
La otra levadura, la Herodes.
And the other leaven is from that of Herod.
¿Quién era Herodes?
Who was Herod?
Era el gobierno.
It was the government.
Era el sistema.
It was the system.
Entonces, la levadura del sistema
and the leaven of the system
y del gobierno
and of the government
también se puede, también puede entrar en la iglesia.
And that can also, that type of leaven can also filter into the church.
Nosotros pertenecemos a un reino.
We belong to a kingdom.
Y en nuestro reino,
and our kingdom,
tenemos un gobierno.
We also have a government.
Y nuestro gobierno,
and our government
tiene una institución, una no sé cómo lo dicen aquí.
¿Tiene qué?
Como decir, las leyes del país.
Ah, and our government as well, that is, the kingdom, also has laws.
Ahora, usted pertenece al reino de los cielos.
And so you now belong to the kingdom of heaven.
No puede dejar que el sistema donde usted vive,
and so you can allow that the system where you live, the government
le
system where you live,
con sus leyes.
Begin to contaminate the kingdom of heaven.
Pastor, ¿y eso puede pasar?
And that can happen.
Sí, hermano. En Cuba, la iglesia ha sido contaminada por el sistema comunista.
Because in Cuba, speaking in general terms, the church has also been contaminated by the government itself.
Pasamos mucho trabajo con los creyentes.
Because they put a lot of pressure on Christians.
Porque desde que son así chiquitico,
because from the time I was just small,
nunca se le menciona a Dios.
They never mentioned God.
Nos enseñan en la escuela que salimos del mono.
They taught us in school that we came from a monkey.
Todos los días de escuela.
Every day in school they were teaching us that.
Todos los estudiantes en Cuba.
All the students in Cuba.
Dicen una consigna.
And they have to ascribe to the following.
La consigna dice, pioneros por el comunismo.
We have to say pioneers for the communism.
Y todos ellos saludan y dicen, seremos como el Che.
And they all say, we will be like Che Guevara. One of the revolutionaries.
Fue un argentino revolucionario.
He was an Argentine that came to work.
Luchó en África.
He worked in, he was a rebel in various countries, including Cuba, along with Fidel Castro.
Fue un hombre rebelde.
He was a very rebellious person.
Que no creía en Dios.
He didn't believe in God.
Entonces, diariamente, un niño cubano.
And so every day, Cuban kids
está declarando
had to be declaring
de que va a ser como Che.
That they're going to be like Che Guevara, the rebel.
Eso es algo bien malo.
That's very bad.
Eso te crea una mentalidad.
That created a mentality.
Te crea una fortaleza en la mente.
It becomes like a fortress in the mind.
Te crea paradigmas en la mente.
And it begins to put paradigms within your mind.
Las personas crecen con miedo.
And so people grow, but with fear.
Por el mismo sistema.
They grow, but with fear of the system.
Las personas crecen con una mentalidad de no puedo.
And so many times people grow up with a mentality, we can't do it.
Una mentalidad negativa.
A negative mentality.
Una mentalidad de lo imposible.
And a mentality, it's impossible.
Porque son tan escasos recursos.
Because the resources are so limited.
Que para ellos es imposible.
And so for them it's impossible to bring about a solution to
este
the
es
situation.
El sistema contaminando a la iglesia.
And that is a system, that system of Herod contaminating the church.
En Primera de Corintios,
in 1 Corinthians,
en el capítulo cinco,
in verse chapter 5,
del uno al seis,
from 1 to 6,
Pablo también le dice ahí, una pequeña porción de levadura leuda toda la masa.
And again Paul comes back and says, oh, just a small portion of leaven or of yeast will affect the whole mass.
Ahí teníamos otro problema.
There we had a different problem.
Había un hombre que se estaba acostando, tenía sexo con la mujer de su papá.
It is because, as you mentioned, Paul calls out the immorality when one of the famous people within the church was having sexual relations with his own stepmother.
Y Pablo decía, saquen ese fornicario en medio de la iglesia.
And Paul said, get that fornicator out of the church.
Lo que para nosotros es normal,
what to us may be normal,
no quiere decir que sea lo correcto.
Doesn't mean that it's right.
Hoy en día están casándose los homosexuales.
Today, homosexuals are getting married.
Las iglesias están casando los homosexuales.
In some churches, they're actually performing the marriages for the homosexuals.
El gobierno defiende a los homosexuales.
The government defends the homosexual.
Pero, ¿cuál es la posición de la iglesia?
But what's the position of the church?
Porque sea normal, ¿va a ser lo correcto?
Just because it's normal, does that mean it's going to be right?
Esa es levadura de Herodes dentro
That's
de la iglesia.
The leaven of Herod.
Que contamina toda la masa.
That contaminates the whole mass.
Tengo muchos ejemplos para ponerles, hermano.
I have many examples to put before
Pero
you.
No conozco bien su cultura.
But I don't know your culture.
Pero usted que vive aquí,
but you who live here,
su reino, su gobierno,
your kingdom,
su partido,
and your party,
su manera de dirigir la iglesia,
the way you direct the church,
no es demócrata ni republicano.
Remember, it's not Democrat and it's not Republican.
Ni es comunista.
And it's not communist.
La iglesia se rige por el gobierno del reino de los cielos.
Because the church is governed by the
Aleluya.
Government of the heavens.
Sin querer.
Pardon?
Sin querer.
Without wanting.
El sistema ha entrado dentro de la iglesia.
So that the system from the world does not infiltrate the
Hoy en
church.
La iglesia vamos a tomar una decisión.
Today we're going to make a decision.
Y entonces votamos.
And so we vote.
Si hay 50 más uno,
and if there's 50% plus one,
es lo correcto.
Then it's done.
Eso no pasa aquí, eso pasa en Cuba.
But I'm sure that doesn't happen that way, but that's the way it happens in Cuba.
Eso en Cuba. Ahora le pregunto, ¿la mayoría tiene la razón?
And so I ask, is the majority always right?
Puede ser en algunos casos.
There's many times when the majority
pero no siempre,
may be right.
Pero no siempre tiene razón.
But remember that the majority is not always right.
Mandaron 12 espías a la tierra prometida.
They sent 12 spies to the promised land.
10 dijeron que no se podía entrar.
10 came back and said, we can't do it.
2 dijeron que sí se podía entrar.
But 2 said, yes, we can enter in.
Por la decisión demócrata.
But because it was a democratic decision.
Basada en el temor.
Based on fear.
Basada en la religiosidad,
based on religiousness,
en el legalismo,
and legalism,
tuvieron que estar 40 años caminando en el desierto.
They had to work 40 years through the desert.
Porque se ha introducido el sistema
because
dentro de la iglesia.
The system of Herod had infiltrated the what we would call church.
Y no estamos adaptados a escuchar la voz de Dios.
And we're not always in tune to hear God's voice.
Y preguntarle a Dios, ¿qué tú quieres que yo haga?
And say, God, what do you want for us at this point?
¿Qué dicen los hermanos que oran en la iglesia?
What are you saying? What we want to hear and we want to hear as we pray in the church.
¿Dónde están los profetas?
Where are the prophets?
En estos tiempos.
In these times.
Y eso la iglesia lo ha perdido.
The church has lost them.
Porque hemos sido contaminados.
Because we have been contaminated.
Por levadura farisea.
From with the leaven of the Pharisees
y Herodiana.
And the leaven of Herod.
¿Están conmigo?
Are you with me?
Yeah. Hallelujah. How many say hallelujah? How many say glory to God? Hallelujah. Hermanos, necesitamos la levadura del reino.
We need the leaven from the kingdom.
Y pastor, ¿cuál es la levadura del reino?
What is the leaven of the kingdom?
Hay dos cosas.
There's just two things
que destacan la levadura del reino.
That it characterizes the leaven from the kingdom.
Una es lo sobrenatural.
And one is we will see the supernatural.
O lo extraordinario.
Or the extraordinary.
La iglesia ha perdido eso también.
The church has lost that.
Hemos perdido las señales, los milagros.
We've lost the signs, the wonders
que Jesús hacía.
That Jesus did.
Y él mismo dijo que nosotros también haríamos.
And he said that you would do in even greater things than these.
Eso es levadura del reino.
That leaven from the kingdom of heaven.
Lo sobrenatural acelera el proceso.
Because when the supernatural happens, it speeds up the growth.
Y lo que te toma 10 años para hacer.
And what might take 10 years to accomplish
en lo sobrenatural,
in the supernatural,
te toma 4 años nada más.
You may only do 4 years.
Nosotros no tenemos los recursos que ustedes tienen.
We don't have the resources that you have.
No tenemos los templos que ustedes tienen.
We don't have the beautiful temples that you have.
Mi templo es mi casa.
Because our church, my temple, is my house.
He tenido que quitar la pared de la sala.
I had to take off the wall of the living room.
La otra pared del comedor.
And then I had to knock out the next wall, which went to the dining room.
Mucha gente.
Because there's many people.
Otra pared.
So then I had to take out another wall.
Primer cuarto.
Of the first bedroom.
Hoy usted va a mi casa y no tengo donde recibirle.
And now you come to my house, I don't even have anywhere to receive you.
Me quedé solamente con un cuarto para mí y un cuarto para mi hijo.
Because we ended up with just one room for my wife and I and one room for my son.
Pero el reino de los cielos está allí.
But the kingdom of God is there.
Hallelujah. Diariamente ocurren sanidades y milagros.
Daily we're seeing healings and we're seeing miracles.
Las personas que son del Partido Comunista aceptan a Jesús.
And those who are from the Communist Party, when they accept Jesus,
entregan sus carneses.
They give their communist card up.
Y Dios está haciendo algo lindo en Cuba.
And God's doing something beautiful in Cuba.
Pero es porque hemos creído a Dios y creemos que Dios es real y es el mismo ayer, hoy y siempre.
But it's because God is real and he's the same yesterday, today and forever.
El problema es que nunca vas a llegar más lejos lo que llegue tu revelación.
Remember that we can try many things, but God has to reveal us the way.
Pero nos tenemos miedo a caminar en las aguas.
Sometimes, you know, we don't want to walk over the water.
Y es más cómodo estar en la barca.
We have fear to walk on the water. It's more comfortable just stay in the boat.
Es más cómodo estar debajo de la casa de campaña y no frente a Goliat.
It's easier to stay in the tent and not go out of the tent to encounter Goliath.
Y eso es lo que nos ha pasado.
And this is what happens.
La otra característica de la levadura del reino.
The other characteristic of the leaven that comes from the kingdom of heaven
son los principios del reino.
Are the principles of the kingdom.
Jesús le dijo a Pedro,
Jesus said to Peter,
tú eres Pedro y sobre esta roca edificaré mi iglesia.
Peter, your name is Peter, but over this rock we will build my church.
Dice, y a ti te daré las llaves del reino de los cielos.
And I will give you the keys to the kingdom of heaven.
Las llaves son los principios del reino de los cielos.
And those keys are the principles of the kingdom.
Principios son leyes.
Principles are laws.
Que no hay ni que orar para que se cumplan.
And you don't have to even pray that they come about.
Simplemente usted lo ejecuta.
You just have to exercise them and they will come about.
Y tiene resultado.
And they will give result.
Un avión no vuela porque el piloto lo hace volar.
An airplane doesn't fly because the pilot makes it fly.
Los pilotos no hacen volar el avión.
The pilots don't make the plane fly.
Lo que hace volar el avión es una ley.
What makes the planes fly is a law.
La ley aerodinámica.
It's the aerodynamic law, the law of aerodynamics.
Que es con la velocidad más el viento hace que el avión se levante.
The speed against the wind and it lifts up.
Así mismo en lo espiritual.
And the same thing is true in the spiritual realm.
Hay leyes.
There are laws.
Que cuando usted las ejecuta.
That when you exercise those laws.
Lo van a levantar para que usted despegue.
You're going to start flying.
Usted siembra un árbol o una matica.
You see just a small plant, a small tree.
Usted no tiene que orar para que crezca el Señor.
You don't have to say there, Lord, make that tree grow. Make
Señor,
it grow, Lord.
Que me dé fruto, Señor.
Man, give me fruit, Lord.
No, no. Usted usa un principio.
You just use the principle of
la
the kingdom.
La siembra en la tierra.
You just plant it.
La riega.
You water it.
Con agua, fertilizantes.
You water it, you cultivate it.
Y usted va a obtener lo que quiere.
And you will receive what you want.
En el reino de Dios, usted ejecuta los principios y usted va a obtener lo que quiere.
In the kingdom of God, if you exercise the principles of the kingdom, you will have the result.
Por eso necesitamos la levadura.
And so for that reason, we need the leaven.
Necesitamos empezar a establecer principios en nuestras vidas.
We need to have the leaven from the kingdom and to begin establishing those principles in our heart, in our lives.
Y los resultados vendrán solos.
And the results will come on their own.
En un espacio de dos años.
In a space of just 2 years,
fundamos 11 iglesias.
We were able to plant 11 additional congregations.
2 años nada más.
2 years.
Estuvimos 11 años para fundar 11 iglesias.
We worked 11 years to plant 11 churches.
¿Y cómo pudimos fundar 11 en 2 años?
So then how can we plant 11 more in just 2 years?
Porque las iglesias en Estados Unidos,
because the churches in the United States,
empezaron ayudando por primera vez en la historia.
They began to help us for the first time in our history.
Ayudaron a acelerar el proceso.
They helped to accelerate the process.
¿Y cómo nos ayudaron?
And how they help us?
Muy sencillo.
It's very simple.
Le dimos una bicicleta a cada misionero.
We gave a bicycle to each missionary pastor.
Y $20 mensuales.
And we started giving them $20 a month.
Eso nada más.
Just with that.
Hizo que el crecimiento se acelerara de 11 años a 2 años nada más.
So that meant that all we had done in 11 years, we were now able to do in just 2 years.
Ustedes tienen recursos en sus manos.
You have resources in your hands.
No dejen perder lo otro.
And it's not just to lose it.
Dice Pablo, perdón, Juan, en el libro de Apocalipsis.
And the Apostle John says in the book of
Revelation, a la iglesia de Éfeso,
and to the Ephesus church, to the church in Ephesus,
conozco tu arduo trabajo.
He says, I know your hard work.
Conozco tu buena doctrina.
I know your good doctrine.
Conozco que has probado que son apóstoles.
I know that you have proven those who are apostles.
Y no soporta los nicolaitas.
And those who are apostles, false apostles.
Pero,
but,
diga conmigo, pero.
Say, but.
Diga, but.
But.
But. Siempre hay un but en nuestras vidas.
There's always comes that point where there's that transition in our lives.
Esta iglesia había perdido su primer amor.
That church in Ephesus had lost its first love.
¿Cuál era el primer amor?
What was its first love?
Dícele, acuérdate de dónde has caído y haz las primeras obras.
Remember from where you have fallen and do your first works.
¿Cómo comenzó esta iglesia?
How this church began.
¿Cuántos años llevan, pastor?
How many, about when was this church planted? 48
años. El fundador no fue usted.
And you weren't the founder of the church, right?
No pierdan esos primeros 5 años comenzó la iglesia.
So don't forget the first 5 years that this church lived.
Porque eso fue lo que hizo levantar este lugar.
Because that's what raised up this church.
Dios les bendiga.
God bless you.
Y espero que Dios le haya hablado a sus vidas.
And I trust that God has spoken to your lives. God bless you.
Please remain standing. This church has a rich history. Some of the best pastors and preachers and leaders to ever grace the pulpits of the Wesleyan Church have been pastors of this church. But this is 2015, by God's choice. And we are on the border between maintenance and monument. We can either refire our passion and our mission, or we can die. God has brought a man from Cuba who knows almost nothing about this church, except me being with him in Cuba twice. And he prayed that God would give him fresh bread for us. And you may have just heard the most important message that's ever been preached in this church. We have a choice. God will use somebody to build his kingdom. Our choice is, will it be us? Or will we hold on to our past and our traditions and the ways that we like things? Thank you, Pastor Younio, for being obedient to the voice of the Holy Spirit and allowing him to speak to us this morning. It was God's voice that we heard through you today. Shall we pray? Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you today for your rich gifts. You have given us so much. And others often have so little. And yet those who have little appreciate much. And those of us who have much often appreciate little. Our lives are like a blade of grass, a flower that blooms for a moment and then passes away. We have but a few short years in this world, and we can use it on ourselves, or we can yield it to you in your kingdom. And Lord, I pray for every person that's part of Calvary Wesleyan Church that right now, this morning, that we would yield ourselves to you and say, dear God, build your kingdom here. Use us any way you choose. Help us to release our hands from control. Help us to stop demanding our own way. Help us to stop looking back to the past. Help us to be filled with your Spirit anew and afresh. And give us a vision and a passion to reach the world for you today. Fill us with a passion to be the church of Jesus Christ. We can argue politics. We can complain about conditions in our world and in our country. We can disagree over all kinds of stuff. But Lord, help us today to yield ourselves to you and say, dear God, build your kingdom here. And thank you for inviting us to be part of what you want to do. Please, Lord, don't pass us by. Use us, Lord. We thank you for Pastor Younio, for the boldness that he has to declare his word, your word, in his country. We thank you for Pastor Rick and Clara and how you use them, not in one country, but in multiple countries, to proclaim your gospel. Many places where there's limited religious liberties. Bless these men and their families for the sacrifices that they make. And oh dear God, don't let this day go by without blessing us and filling us and opening our eyes to what you want to do in us and through us. 1,000 years from now, it won't matter what kind of car we drove or what kind of house we live in or whether we listened to music we liked or didn't like when we went to church. But 1,000 years from now, it'll make all the difference in the world if we used our resources to reach people with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Thank you for the privilege of being here this morning. Help us to sow seeds, to water and cultivate them, and to watch you grow them for your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Send us forth now to be your people, to be your light, to be the gospel in this world. In Jesus' name we pray.